Alrighty, so yeah, today I'm dealing with a peculiar situation. I painted the room a little bit because the mold was growing through, and I've added particle filter. Unfortunately, on this little Linux situation, we don't really have cute filters, so you're stuck with, you know, the Linux people are kind of stuck with some pretty basic ones, and yeah, so here we are, and I don't know, it's kind of tedious, because the Windows people, they have luxurious backgrounds and things, you know, whisking through, and I don't know, I just haven't been able to just to find it here for Linux. But so yeah, with particles, they're cheering me up anyway, a little magic. Anyway, I wanted to talk about the cause. It's called, oh gosh, I briefly saw the word, and I've heard it maybe once or twice. It's called Cosmeanthropic, and I believe there's even extra to it, and it's about cosmoanthropic situations of the imagination. So when we're having these situations of the imagination, like, I watched a video with the women from Iceland, they've apparently see elves, okay, and I'm like, whoa, likeness and kind, because I had a similar situation in Corsica, and I'm like, well, maybe this is an island thing. I didn't actually see necessarily elves like you're thinking, like, you know, all pruny and with strange distorted hats. They were more kind of like trolls, but they had a village. And it was like visiting another plane of existence. Like, they live all the time there, and I somehow tapped through to their plane of existence and got to eyeball how they live. So it was kind of interesting. So that was my experience. Now, whether that was, you can blame it on a mushroom, or something else, but very interestingly, it was an island also, and I haven't had that experience here on shoreland, so maybe it is something to do with special places on the earth that actually have shared I guess we could call it a shared breach of space. It's like, wait a minute, you know, we're here also, and maybe that just is the way it goes. Maybe those, I'm talking clearly, very clearly, you know, for a very long time, you know, to witness, you know, 15 minutes, an entire village of these creatures and their little homes, their habitats, or whatever. At first I thought it was a movie, and I'm like, no, it's not a movie. It's not actually a movie. These are for reals. And that moment, it was like a special ordinance given. So I'm like, well, thank you. You know, I had the privilege to go and to see this magical world. And so it was kind of fun. It was fun. But I guess what I'm trying to talk about is, because there are all these other people who have never seen the elves, they'll be like naysaying you. But in the same token, you know, to hell with them. You know, if I saw the elves, I saw the elves. I saw the trolls. Then I saw them. So then that's the way it goes. And if it was a matrix breach, people talk about matrix breaches. You know, that, oh well, maybe it was just like some video game. It just slathered through on the what do you call it, the Wi-Fi. And no, I don't believe it was anything like that, actually. So when we're dealing with imagination, and no, it wasn't like a psychotropic high where, you know, you're just like, oh wow, you know, I'm just like, you know, that's the most beautiful sunset I've ever seen or whatever. It wasn't that type of a situation. It was just a reality, just an open reality. And when you're having a reality situation with the imagination, it's not a hallucination any longer. It's actually like there's a plane of existence that also is shared in the same plane that we are in right now. And for some reason, with world shift, the way the world shifts, there was a way through, and I got to vision that, so that was kind of neat. So anyway, so I have a kind of a weird deal with the women of the Iceland also have seen elves. So it's a strange phenomenon. And yeah, I witnessed the village, and then also further up on the hill there was another like an organization area of maybe 4 or 5 huts that they moved over up on the hill. And I believe I was with another person also at the time, later on, the one on the hill, who also validated it and was with me. And so yeah, and I think my dog even took a leak on one of the huts. Nobody was there at the time on the one on the hill, but yeah. So these types of stories, they're like, well, maybe you're just a crazed nut or something. But in reality, there was no movie being made, and so I have to come up with another set of story. Now, is the imagination plane itself something that is something that grand that I actually could create that much of it, you know? Or in reality, is this a real we'll call it a subjective place where they live and breathe and have lives, you know, with logical problems just like we have here in this plane. So yeah. Anyway, so I know a lot of people are talking about dragons lately, or this, that, and the other, and so it's just kind of opened up the subject, because we have there was a dragon find in Japan, a dinosaur uncovered, but it was a real dragon with the wings, and so it's kind of interesting, an interesting find there in Japan those people. Anywho, yeah, it's been kind of a rough day. I'm getting slammed down by people. So it's almost like the slammed down by people group. Maybe, I don't know who they are. They want to divorce me. All these people want to divorce me. you know, it's like they all want to share some terrible marital fight like I had with my husband, you know. I don't understand it, you know. It seems like a big divorce. Everybody in the United States, since I've come back here to the US, they just want to be like my husband and in a marital dispute, you know what I mean? When I mean marital dispute, I mean they just are taking his side, like he's does he give them money? I don't know. All these things, you know, it's because, yeah, just don't talk to her. Don't talk to her, you know. And I'm like, okay. So I have a list of all the people, and I guess it's pretty much everybody that I come in contact with. So, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's a, what do you call it? At some point, it becomes a lynch mob. A lynch mob group against me, and I'm not really sure why you all want to be that. Maybe you're paid extra monies, I don't know. But I did invent perpetual motion, and maybe somebody is getting paid money on the back end of it to slow down that momentum. They're trying to oust me, I don't know. You know, all of those stupidities. Anyway, so you all are winning in your deliberations of yeah, you're all winning, because I'm only one person, and the lynch mob group is you know, a lynch mob group, and I guess, you know, you're all blaming me because things didn't go great with my husband. Is that what it is? Like, what a difficult chore that you even exist. Why don't you die already? This is going on, and it's just tiring. It's a tiring group of people, and Anyway, I'm gonna go back and write some more books. Anyhow, and try not to cry because you guys really, you don't deserve me. You just don't deserve me.